Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, grade 10? Today, inshallah, I'm going to re-explain the experiment we've did in the we've already taken in the class, which is verifying Ohm's law for ohmic conductor. So you have this one already. It's uploaded in MS team file section. I want you to download it. You read the procedures really carefully and open the simulation. So first step, you have to open the simulation. Here I have opened the simulation. As we know, Ohm's law give you a relation between voltage. If I increase the voltage, what will happen to the current? The current as well will be increased. So in the experiment, I created a table for you. I want you to keep the resistance fixed at 500 ohm. Each time we're going to play with the voltage and record the value of the current. So we start with 0.5 volt. Okay. And record this value, it's 1 milliamp. And then we'll go to, so we record it here. You have to create Excel sheet. I've already shared with you this Excel sheet. Okay, so here you have to write the values here. So current 1 milliamp, then increase the value of the voltage, go to 2 volt. Okay. And record the value of the current here. I have 4 milliamp. Finish the experiment, finish taking all this this measurement type. Next step, what we need to do from this experiment? We need to verify Ohm law. We need, after we're done, to draw a relationship between voltage and current. We should get a straight line because it's ohmic. It obey Ohm's law, so I should get a straight line. As we know, the slope of this straight line should give you what? The resistance. So I know is a voltage, V, we know we studied V, equals what? I times R. So if I draw a relationship between voltage and current, I should get a straight line. The equation of a straight line, Y, equal MX plus B. I don't have B, Y intercept, I started from zero, so B is zero. V, it's what? My Y axis. I, the current, is the x-axis. So R will represent what? The slope. The slope, which is rise over run. So R, V over I, or the slope of V versus I. So second step, I need to convert from milliamp to amp, so divided by 1,000. So I'm gonna write equal. Go to the 1 amp, put the mouse on it, okay? Forward slash 1,000 divided by 1,000, hit enter. Okay, go back to the same cell. You see this point to the right corner of the cell. Put the mouse on it till the mouse becomes like a plus sign, and then drag all the values down. Now I need to draw a relation between voltage, so highlight all of these numbers, go to insert, scatter, okay. Now I have the graph. I need to right click, at any point, right click, select data. Edit. I need voltage, name your graph, voltage versus what? Versus current, and current is in amp. Voltage in volt. X-axis, I needed the current, so go and select all of these values. This is my x-axis. Y-axis, I need the voltage. It's already selected for me. Hit OK. OK. Now I need to label my graph, so I go here to the plus sign. Axis, title. Here I need the current. So here's the current. Current, the unit is amp. and y-axis I have voltage, and bayonet is V. What else do I need? I need to show the equation. So go here to add a trend line. Okay, click on add a trend line. I need it linear. I need the intercept start from zero. Display equation on chart. And that's it. So if I ask you what is the value of the resistance, you'll tell me, okay, it's the slope, and the slope here is what? It's 500. After you're done with everything, I don't want you to upload this one on ManageBack. This one is for you to know exactly what I want you to include in your lab report. So what you are going to upload basically on ManageBack, it's not this one, is the lab report format. Which is this one. And you have all of these files, all of them is already on MSTM in the file section, you'll find them. So this one, you fill this one and you upload it in ManageBack. And before you upload it, I want you to read carefully. What is the problem question? It's a question that includes both independent and dependent variable. So first I have to know what is my independent variables. It's the variable you are changing. Go to the experiment. I was changing what exactly? Okay, what is your dependent variable? Is what you're measuring. Each time I was measuring what exactly? And control variables, the variable that you kept fixed during the experiment. Which one I didn't play with it, I didn't touch it at all. Which one I kept it fixed during the experiment. Okay, so I have to list it here. This could have more than one variable if it's a real experiment. If we did it in real experiment, it could be the room temperature, the wire itself, many factors if it's a real experiment. What is the material and method? Even its simulation, you have to write about the safety. Method or procedure, you should write them in steps. One, step one, we did that. Step two, we did that. And I wrote the steps for you. So just rewrite them with your own words. Okay? Results and analysis, your table, you have to paste, you have to copy the table from here, this one. And this graph, take a screenshot or copy it and paste them here. This is the result and analysis. This is the result. Analysis actually is the answer of this question. You grab the data, you start to explain to me what is the relation, ship is given in the graph, calculate the value of the slope, what does the slope represent, okay? You're done with this, write your conclusion. Conclusion, start to explain your result. Answer the question, the question here, the problem question. Now this one, we have to go back to this. Question that relate both independent and dependent variable. For example, like I say, if I increase the voltage, the current will increase or the current will decrease. It could be true, it could be wrong. After we do the experiment, okay, we need to verify this hypothesis by doing the experiment, and then we restate the hypothesis here at the end in the conclusion. So here, you have to restate the hypothesis. And if we recreate this experiment, we have actual experiment, we have to compare our result with the actual experiment. But this now, we don't have actual experiments, so we need to compare our results. Okay, if we need to compare with actual experiment, for example, my experiment, for example, I'm saying just example, is to calculate the free fall acceleration, which is 9.81, and I've got, when I did the experiment, 11. So it will be the actual value. I have to calculate the percentage difference minus the experimental value that I got when I did the experiment divided by the actual value. Times 100%. This is the percentage difference. For now, we don't have, no need to do this one. After that, you have to write the evaluation. You fill this table. Errors that, or problem you encounter during the problem, how these errors affect your data, and suggestion for improvement. If you have chances, a chance to redo the experiment, what you're going to do. Okay, don't forget to write the aim. Background information minimum, girls, minimum half a page. Maximum 1.5 page. You write brief introduction about the experiment. Put a photo to illustrate Ohm's law experiment. Write the formula you're going to use, and you can comment as well on your data, on your result, okay? And the hypothesis I predict, or I think, or I can use, we prefer to use if-then statement. If, okay, if I increase, for example, the voltage, then the current will decrease, the current will increase. So the if and then, it should include both independent and dependent variable. This experiment, you'll do it inshallah during the class time. And I want you to upload it at the same time on ManageBack. Okay? Good luck.